This video will help you start using WorkFusion Studio and RPA Express. RPA Express is designed to help anyone automate manual tasks, like copying and pasting data from one source to another, sorting emails, locating and extracting information in PDF documents, and other use cases. Let's start the application. The first thing you see after starting RPA Express is the tray menu. It helps you to manage all components of the application. From the tray menu, you can launch WorkFusion Studio, start Control Tower and Workspace, manage your bots, start stop OCR, and open Platform Monitor and File Storage. You will learn about each of these components in the next videos. To start creating recordings, launch WorkFusion Studio and define the location of your workspace. We recommend leaving the default location. Tick the checkbox to always use this workspace by default and press OK. When you launch WorkFusion Studio for the first time, you see the welcome page. Here, you can watch video tutorials, run recording examples, and find useful links to training materials. Let's run one of the recording examples. It opens Notepad application and types in some predefined text. The space where you will create your automated workflows is RPA Recorder. To create a new recording project, press the Start New Recording button on the toolbar menu, type the recording name, and press OK. RPA Recorder consists of four main parts: Actions Library, Recorder Variables, Media Files tab, and Actions Flow Area. If any of these areas hasn't opened in the Recorder window by default, you can open it by clicking Window, Show View. There are two ways to create a recording. The first one is to capture your actions from the screen automatically. Press Replace with New Recording button, perform the actions you want to record, and press Stop. The recorder will capture all your actions. To see the bot perform the captured actions, press Play the Recording button. You can edit the details of recorded actions in the Action Properties window. To capture additional steps for the existing recording, press the Insert Recording button. This panel also contains buttons to publish your ready recording to Control Tower and export them as a bot task or Groovy code. Watch WorkFusion Studio Overview video to learn about the code perspective in RPA Express. In more complicated cases, when automatic capturing is not enough, you can use built-in actions in the Actions library to make your scripts more robust. To add a new action to your recording, you need to select it in the Actions library and drag to the Actions flow. For example, let's create a small script to open Notepad and type in Hello World. The bot will press a key combination, Win plus R, to open the Run dialog, type Notepad, press Enter, and then type Hello World into the opened window. To copy an action, hold the Control button and drag the action to the required place in the recording. To delete an action, select it and press the Delete button on keyboard or use right-click Delete. If you don't know what a specific action does, you can hover the cursor over it and click the link for more information. In the Recorder Variables panel, you can create, edit, or delete your variables. Variables are used for storing initial or runtime data of different types used in your recording. Let's create a variable of type string and assign a value to it. You can edit variable value, type, and name whenever you need. To delete the variable, select it and press the Delete button. In the Media Files tab, you can see and manage all recordings, execution logs, and other files stored in your workspace. Here, you can browse and open your existing recordings and edit them, for example, rename. If you enable the Link with Editor mode, the Media Files tab will automatically open and show the folder with your active recording. On the Toolbar menu, you can find the Preferences button, where you can adjust various RPA Express parameters. To view and edit RPA Recorder preferences, go to WorkFusion Studio RPA Recorder. Watch WorkFusion Studio Overview video to learn more about the preferences. The toolbar also contains the button to open the Inspector tool. Inspector allows you to capture and analyze unique object selectors used for automating desktop applications.